Hi guys, so I wanted to do just a really quick cloth diapering vlog. I am 29 weeks pregnant, currently expecting my first baby, and for a long time, like for years, even before I got pregnant, I've always loved cloth diapers. I've loved the idea of it. I think they're really cute. I mean, there's a lot of cool things about cloth diapers. And it's always been one of my sort of pre-pregnancy hobbies, like looking into cloth diapers and learning everything I can about them. So now that I'm finally expecting my first baby, I finally get to collect a small stash, and I'm really excited to try them once I have my baby. So this video is just gonna be a quick sort of like newborn cloth diaper stash. I don't have a ton of stuff, but I feel like from everything I've seen and read about getting your first stash is not to invest everything all at once until you really learn what you like. So what I decided to do, at least as I start out cloth diapering, is to use pre-folds and flats. That came after a lot of research, and the reason why I decided to start out with pre-folds and flats, two reasons. Maybe three. The third's not as important. But first of all, I like how customizable they are. So before your baby's born, you don't know what kind of body type they're gonna have. You don't know if a all-in-one Charlie Banana or Fuzzy Buns or whatever is going to fit your baby in particular. And so the idea of having a pre-fold or a flat appealed to me because they are so customizable that no matter what size or shape your baby is, you can fold it in such a way to make it fit on your baby. So that was one thing I really liked about the idea of pre-folds and flats, is how customizable they are before you know what shape your baby is going to be. The second thing I was really attracted to by pre-folds and flats were the convenience of laundry. It just seemed so much easier in terms of drying time, and just, you know, you've got just like a white piece of fabric and it's 100% cotton, so you don't have to really know anything special about laundry. It's just like washing any old piece of white cloth. So I liked that, the ease of doing laundry. And then finally, I guess this is the third reason, and it wasn't as important for me, but it still is a factor, and that is the price. Pre-folds and flats and covers, I think, are probably the cheapest way you can go when you're cloth diapering. So without further ado, I will just get right into my stash, show you what I'm starting out with. I'm trying to keep it conservative and just the bare basics, what I need. So to start out with, everything I heard was that you need 24 diapers to have a good stash to last you for 2 days. Like, unless you want to be doing laundry every single day, you really need about 24 diapers. So what I did was I got a pack of 12. They come in 12 pre-folds. These are the newborn. I was in between getting the newborn or the small size, and I decided just to go ahead and get the newborn, and they're really not that expensive. This was like 24 or 25 bucks for a pack of 12 diapers. And these, you know, will last, and I can use them as inserts later on as the baby gets bigger. You know, you can stuff them. So I got 12 of these. These are 100% cotton from the greenmountaindiapers.com website. They're called Cloth Ease. It's the Cloth Ease brand, the orange border, and these are really tiny, really cute. So I've got 12 of these, and then I've got 12 flats. But these actually are not real diapers. These are flour sack towels from Target, and they cost $1 a piece. You get them, I think, in packs of four, and I've got 12 of them. So with the 12 flour sack towels and the 12 pre-folds, I've got 24. And along with those, I got a pack of 6 little snappies to be able to close the diaper depending on what fold I use. I definitely am excited to try the pad fold or the tri-fold where you just stick that into a cover, because that's really easy. But then, of course, there are other folds you can do that require a snappy. So I got 6 snappies, 12 pre-folds, 12 flats, and then my covers. So I put all these covers on my registry, and so I actually didn't purchase any of them myself. My mother-in-law got all of them for me. I have 5 infant cloth diaper covers, or, you know, newborn size, and one of them is a Thirsties size 1, so I think that fits a little longer. Says from 6 to 18 pounds. So this is the Thirsties size 1 cover. I got this in the Velcro because I wanted to get a combination of both Velcro and snaps, partly so that it's easier for my husband or mom or whoever. You know, the Velcro is kind of convenient. It's got different rise settings, so you can make it smaller or bigger, make it last just a little bit longer. So that's one. I've got this cute Romperoos cover, and it's got kangaroos on it. And if you know, my nursery theme is Australian animals and Aboriginal art, so I wanted the kangaroo pattern for that. And then I also have another second Romperoos newborn cover, and this one has foxes and owls possibly, or just foxes. It's really cute. These also, they have different snaps for the rise, and so I'm hoping that they'll last longer than just a couple weeks because of the different rise settings. And then here is another Romperoos cover. I like it. These ones have the double leg gussets, which I've heard are good. And this one also, again, is the Velcro. I think I have two covers that have the Velcro. And then my last cover is Blueberry Capri cover. And this one has numbers on it. My husband is an engineer and he likes math and physics, so I thought it'd be fun to get a cover that he would like with the numbers on it. So those are my 5 newborn covers. And then I also got 3 one-size covers just in case she gets big really fast. This is also Romperoos. I didn't do that on purpose, get all Romperoos. This is a Romperoos cover in pink. And then I got 2 of the Best Bottom covers. These are the same. These are hedgehogs, they're yellow. And so these 3 are one size. I don't think they'll fit her right when she's born, but if she gets big quickly, at least I have something to transition her into. And then on top of my covers, prefolds, and flats, I did get a few. I got 2 all-in-one diapers just to be able to try them out and also to have something cute. And if I wanted to put her in like a nice outfit, I could use these. So these are the Thirsties natural all-in-one diapers, and I have 2 of these. They're the same print. It's a cute girly print. I got the idea for these diapers from a review from Naturally Thrifty Mom. I think that's her YouTube name. I'll link her channel down below. She reviewed these and I thought they looked really cute, and so I put these on my registry as well. These are all-in-one diapers. The inserts are sewn in there, so it makes it an all-in-one. And so besides the 2 all-in-one, newborn all-in-ones, I also have 2 newborn fitted diapers. And these are also Thirsties, and they're natural. It's a bamboo-cotton combination. And I thought it would be nice to have 2 fitted diapers. Firstly, just to try the fitted diaper style, but then also I've heard that they're better for overnight. So I wanted to have 2 options for overnight diapers. So those are my fitted. And these, of course, would require a waterproof cover over them, but I've already got my 5 covers. So there you go. I got the 2 fitted, the 2 all-in-ones, 12 prefolds, and 12 flats. My covers and my snappies. I put these on my registry kind of for later. They won't fit her when she's newborn, but I got a bunch of bamboo inserts for later on. And it's just nice to have these beforehand. And then I also got a pack of 15 cloth wipes. I think these are bamboo wipes or something. And then I also just have a bunch of random washcloths from Target to use for cloth wipes. Okay, I'm almost done with my stash here. Last 3 items I have for my cloth diapering stash for my newborn, my brand new stash. I've got this tiny little wet bag to put in the diaper bag. This is for diaper changes when we're out of the house. You know, you can, it's waterproof on the inside and it's got a zipper. So that's for when we're out of the house. And then I got 2 large hanging wet bags for the nursery. I decided to go with a hanging wet bag instead of a pail and a pail liner because I felt like, my nursery is really small. It's a small room, and I felt like this was more streamlined. It took up less space. I like that you could hang it on the door handle of the nursery, or if we want to change it in the bathroom, we could hang it on the door handle in the bathroom, and it doesn't take up as much space having a whole pail. I just felt like it was easier. If I find that the hanging wet bag is not convenient once I try it out, then I will get a pail and a pail liner. So this is one, and then I got a second one, both in the chevron pattern. And I got two because, again, that was recommended, like when you're doing one load of laundry, you need a second bag to have for diaper changes, like while you're doing laundry, and the other one's in the wash. So, okay, that is my entire cloth diaper stash. And since I have never actually cloth diapered a baby, I don't have any reviews, I don't have any favorites, nothing. But I did, for my sake mainly, want to have this as a record for my very first introduction to cloth diapers. This is where I'm starting at, this is my starting point. And hopefully after she's born, I will do some more cloth diaper updates, let you know how it's going, and what my favorite diapers are, and how I'm using them, and so on and so forth. So for now, that is my cloth diaper stash. I cannot wait to put them on her when she's born. I'm sure they're gonna be so adorable. And yeah, if you have any questions, go ahead and leave them in the comments, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.